Welcome back to this video series, St. James and Good Shepherd Community. Good to have you with us. We're going to take a moment here to address the time of year and season that we're entering into. And I'm speaking now not of the calendar season, but liturgical season. This is being recorded as we've just completed the Feast of Christ the King and are transitioning now to a new liturgical year and the first Sunday of Advent. And so isn't it appropriate to pause for a moment and reflect upon what we're leaving behind in terms of the past liturgical year, and to perhaps make resolution about new commitment and new focus for Advent, the season of joyful anticipation, and our new faith year. Holy Mother Church, in her wisdom, purposely puts the Feast of Christ the King on the last Sunday of each liturgical year, and once every 3 years includes on that Sunday the Matthew 25 reading about the six corporal works of mercy. For those who were at Mass at St. James this weekend, you heard us break that open. What I'd like to do with you here now is to think about corporal works of mercy, what we might call charity and justice, and think about charity and justice in a different way. And that is what the church calls direct service and advocacy. Direct service being literally that direct thing we do to bring forth one of the corporal works of mercy. Advocacy, however, has to do with changing the structures of what are in place so that we might no longer need to address what is the charity event. I'll give you some examples. In the corporal works of mercy, we hear first, feed the hungry. St. James, Good Shepherd, you do that so well as communities. The example I would give is both parishes' involvements in St. Ben's meal program, where we prepare food, bring it, and serve it to those who are hungry. What I'm asking you to consider this Advent, to think about as a resolution for this year, is entering into advocacy so that we might look at the laws and structures and policies that might be causing hunger in our communities. So we might ask ourselves, why are the homeless having to come to St. Ben's? Or families in need in those communities, why are they having to come there to receive food? Why are we not caring for them as a society in their own homes and places? So, if you will, a step of charity, direct service, and a step of justice, in this case, advocacy. We hear also in these corporal works of mercy the call from Christ to care for the homeless. So, Good Shepherd and St. James, as communities, again, we have been doing that well for many years. We support in ministry and presence services like Repairs of the Breach and like Guest House, where we go to stand with the homeless and help them with their temporal needs, with medicine, with clothing, with personal care items. But this Advent, could we consider advocacy? Could we consider contacting our legislators in respect and dignity, not as a political Democrat or Republican issue, but as a call from Christ to look at the structures that are causing homelessness? So many veterans, so many mentally ill are on the streets. A great percentage of the homeless come from those two communities. Surely all of us respect our veterans, and all of us want the mentally ill to be properly cared for. Could we this Advent recommit as disciples to finding a way to change our structures so that those communities are properly cared for and would not have to go to organizations like Repairs of the Breach and to guest house. We hear in the corporal works of mercy, Matthew 25, that we are to welcome the stranger. St. James and Good Shepherd, both communities do that very well. A great example is that as we enter into our communities each weekend, we have greeters. People welcome us into the worship space. During the Mass, we welcome each other with the sign of peace. We do welcome the stranger well. But I'd ask that we apply that to the larger context in society. There's much debate now about immigration. There's much debate now about what we do with refugees. I would ask that we consider asking our legislators, state and federal, to set up just structures so that we would welcome again, like most of our forefathers were welcomed to this country, in a way that would at the same time protect our security, but would be returning America to being the welcoming community that it has been in our history. We hear in the corporal works of mercy that we are to visit the sick and that we are to visit the prisoner. So, in visiting the sick, we do that very well. Both parishes have ministries that are pastoral care ministries. So we have priests and deacons and many who go to the hospitals, who are available to go to homes, to pray with those who are sick, to bring them viaticum and communion. So we should continue to do that. But this year, as we transition to our new liturgical year, could we consider thinking about health care? The United States Catholic Conference of Bishops has been very vocal in this space, asking that we have appropriate and just health care for all people. Yes, anybody can go to a hospital or to a medical facility and receive catastrophic health care even if they don't have it. But there are many areas of health care that are not addressed in those times and those places. Could we pray about and think about recommitting to being sure that all God's children are giving the respect and dignity they deserve, including being given appropriate and adequate health care? I'd enter into this review of discussion, but also reflection and commitment, respect life. Christ didn't mention it specifically in the six corporal works of mercy, but certainly respecting and giving dignity, as the Catholic Church does, to all life, from conception to natural death. Surely that is, as Christ said, caring for the least among us. Who could be more powerless? Who could be more least among us than that infant, that living being in the mother's womb? So could we not then commit anew to asking our legislators to consider laws that would respect the child in the womb, to reconsider allowing abortions while respecting the rights of women so that they're given the proper programs and support after giving birth and would not be tempted to have an abortion? And as we teach in the Catholic Church, respecting life from conception to natural death, could we not consider end-of-life issues? Could we not consider things like the death penalty? Could we not be more consistent in respecting all life in every instance from conception to natural death? My brothers and sisters, this is challenging stuff. But while we are entering into Advent to think and pray and reflect in anticipation of Christ coming more fully into our lives, let us also take this time to pray and reflect on how we can be Christ more fully in the world by taking these corporal works of mercy and respect for life even more seriously this year and committing to having a direct service approach and an advocacy approach, serving those communities directly but asking for change in policy in society. That's it for today. Thank you for coming to this moment in time. As always, I welcome any of you contacting me to further these discussions or others that you would want to have. And I welcome your suggestions of other topics we might address in these regular video moments as we continue to grow as disciples and to support each other as Christ has asked us to do at this time of year. So may the peace of Christ be with you, and let us go, therefore, in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thank you. I look forward to seeing you again soon.